Griselda Guerra here is on a national speaking tour to talk about the literacy campaign and showing the film Maestra, which is a very good short film. She was the youngest teacher in the literacy campaign. She was 7 at the time and taught some older person about my age how to read and write. And then later she became a math professor. And later in life, when I knew her in Cuba 2 years ago, she was working in that Sociedad Cubana de Psicología, the Cuban Psychological Society, focusing on issues of racism, sexual violence, and homophobia in Cuba and how to help resolve the problems. So that's finished. So, if Griselda, you mean?
Bueno, buenas noches. Tengo el gusto de estar presente para ustedes aquí para hablar sobre mi país en diferentes aspectos, sobre todo, fundamentalmente, en el aspecto de lo que es el desarrollo que ha adquirido la mujer a lo largo del triunfo de la revolución durante estas décadas y qué cosa es la mujer hoy en día en Cuba.
Good evening. It's a great pleasure to be here with you to be able to talk about different questions of my country, but especially to focus on questions of the development of women in the course of the revolutionary process and what is the situation of women today in Cuba.
Cuando la revolución triunfa el 1 de enero del 59, la mujer era fundamentalmente la ama de casa, la madre, la esposa, que era gobernada por sus padres y después por su marido.
When the revolution triumphed on January 1st, 1959, women in Cuba were essentially were housewives, mothers, daughters. Their lives were ruled by their husbands, by their fathers.
Y es a partir de la campaña de alfabetización que fue una movilización masiva de jóvenes a pedido de Fidel para poder alfabetizar a un pueblo.
And it was beginning with the National Literacy Campaign, which was a massive campaign that mobilized young people. It was proposed by Fidel Castro to teach everybody who did not know how to read and write, how to read and write.
Es que dando respuesta a esta solicitud, nos volcamos y en la mayor parte, el 52% de los alfabetizadores fueron mujeres.
And women joined this campaign in massive numbers. More than half, more than 55% of all the teachers in this campaign were women.
Mujeres en diferentes edades. Por ejemplo, la más pequeña soy yo, que tenía 7 años, pero abarcó todos los estudiantes hasta 12 grado.
It was women of different ages. I was the youngest. I was 7 years old at the time. But there were women of many different ages. It involved students all the way up through the 12th grade.
Imaginen muchachas de sus casas con las condiciones creadas, con baño sanitario, luz eléctrica y demás comodidades.
And imagine, these were young women who were leaving their homes where they had all the comforts of running water, electricity, and so forth.
Ir a vivir con los campesinos en lugares recónditos dentro de las montañas.
And they would go and live with the peasants in remote areas in the mountains.
Durmiendo en la hamaca que se le dio para poder desarrollar sus funciones.
They would sleep in hammocks, which they were given as part of their equipment to help them carry out their responsibilities as brigadistas.
Generalmente siendo la primera vez que se dedicaban a ir a los campos.
For most of them, this was the first time they'd ever been to the countryside.
Y compartieron, tanto hembras como varones, el trabajo de estos campesinos en el propio lugar donde vivían.
And both the young men and the young women shared the work that the peasants carried out.
Desarrollando fundamentalmente labores de la agricultura.
Carrying out fundamentally agricultural labor.
Pues los campesinos vivían del trabajo de la tierra de los latifundistas.
Because the peasants lived from their labor on the land, that is land that had been owned by the big landlords.
Que no eran más que los dueños de las grandes extensiones de tierra.
Which were just the very rich people that owned the big extensions of land.
O sea, la muchacha, la joven cubana, supo instalarse en esas viviendas.
That is, these young Cuban women managed to figure out how to make themselves at home in these living conditions.
Y de manera responsable mantenerse en esos lugares durante meses para poder alfabetizar a familias que lo necesitaban.
And very responsibly be able to maintain themselves in this situation for months. The time was necessary to actually teach people how to read and write.
A partir de ahí, eso fue como el punto de partida para el desarrollo de la mujer en Cuba.
So this really was the taking off point, the launching point for the development of women in Cuba.
Tanto en el aspecto social, laboral, y así como aprendió sus derechos, hasta dónde ella podía llegar.
This was in terms of her social position, her involvement in work, and her beginning to learn about her rights and her position in society.
Al terminar la campaña, el Estado oferta becas para continuar estudios en diferentes carreras.
And when the literacy campaign was over, the state offered everyone scholarships to be able to continue their studies in different fields.
Y se incorporan las mujeres, las muchachas, cuando ya terminaban sus estudios normales de la enseñanza general, se incorporaron a estudiar muchas carreras de las que se estaban ofertando.
And young women, when they finished their basic educational studies, incorporated themselves in very large numbers in professional studies in a wide range of activities.
Una gran cantidad, enamoradas de la enseñanza, producto de la campaña, decidieron ser maestras.
A large number who had learned to love teaching because of their experience in the literacy campaign became teachers.
Lo que era muy necesario porque a partir de la campaña ya la población cubana continuó realizando estudios.
And this was very necessary because the literacy campaign was just the beginning, and on the basis of that, the entire Cuban population was going to continue studying.
Se libraron a lo largo de los años otras batallas. Se continuó después de la batalla el seguimiento que fue hasta tercer grado.
And this educational campaign continued on for years. The first stage was to get everyone up to a third grade level.
En el tiempo continuamos con una nueva batalla que fue la del sexto grado.
And after that came a new battle, which was the campaign for the sixth grade.
Y más adelante la del noveno grado.
And after that, the campaign for ninth grade.
Imaginen ustedes que las mujeres hoy en día estudiamos las carreras que nosotros decidamos porque no hay diferencia de género.
And you got to think about it. Today in Cuba, women study whatever career they want to because there's no difference between the genders in Cuba.
Y como los estudios en Cuba son gratuitos y obligatorios a partir de los 5 años,
and since education is free and obligatory in Cuba, beginning with the people when you're 5 years old,
la mujer no ha tenido ataduras de ningún tipo para equipararse al hombre en el derecho al estudio y al trabajo.
Women have had no obstacles and been able to prepare themselves for education on an equal footing with men.
Recibimos iguales salarios que los hombres.
We receive the same pay as men.
Y nosotras somos la mayor parte de los profesionales en Cuba.
And women make up the majority of the professionals in Cuba.
Hay grandes cantidades de científicas que son mujeres.
There's a large number of scientists who are women.
Trabajando en los polos científicos donde se están descubriendo y se están analizando muchas cosas buenas para la salud del hombre.
Many of them work in the research centers where many important new discoveries are being made that benefit the health of people.
Que compartimos con otros países.
This is something we share with other countries.
Ojalá no tuviéramos el bloqueo y pudiéramos compartir más con ustedes.
And I wish we didn't have the U.S. blockade imposed on Cuba, because then we could share this with the United States also.
Tenemos muy buenos medicamentos y muy buenos científicos.
We have very good medication we've developed, and we have very good scientists.
Dentro de las cuales hay mujeres que son líderes en este momento, tanto en el área donde están trabajando, son dirigentes en ese lugar.
And amongst these scientists, many of them are women, including many who are leaders. That is, there are women who are leaders of the research centers where they work.
Como en su propio trabajo, como científicas.
And in their own scientific field that they work in.
Tenemos gran cantidad de doctoras en pedagogía.
We have many women who are doctors of pedagogy or education.
Ingenieras en diferentes especialidades.
Engineers in different specialties.
Y cada quien, yo decía hoy en un grupo de jóvenes, de mujeres que estaban estudiando en una escuela que di una presentación de la película, la mujer propiamente es la que se pone su techo.
And so, as I said to a group of young people at a presentation I had recently where I showed the film Maestra, it is the women themselves, the only ones who impose the glass ceiling above themselves.
O sea, es la mujer la que decide hasta dónde llegar.
That is, it's the women themselves who decide how far they can go.
Imaginen ustedes, mujeres independientes como somos nosotras.
And imagine women like ourselves, as independent as we are.
Con una definición de nuestro objetivo.
When we have ourselves defined what our goals are.
Que alguien, algún hombre, osara acosarnos.
And imagine if any man would dare to harass us.
Eso en Cuba no ocurre.
This just doesn't happen in Cuba.
Puede que se dé, no sé, algún caso, alguna mujer que salga sola, no sé. Y bueno, hay algún hombre aberrado que sencillamente quizás haga algo. Pero en Cuba no existen casos de acoso sexual.
It's possible that it happens. A woman is out by herself and some guy, really strange guy, does try to do something to her. But you really don't have this kind of sexual harassment in Cuba.
Que nosotros dominemos, como yo veo, yo llegué aquí el 24 de septiembre.
And I've seen, I came here to the United States on the 24th of September.
A los Estados Unidos, y yo me he quedado asombrada.
And I was really shocked.
De la cantidad de casos de acoso sexual en artistas, en deportistas, yo, es algo que no puedo entender.
The number of instances of sexual harassment carried out by figures in arts, in sports, this is just something that I had never seen before.
Eso en Cuba no existe.
This doesn't exist in Cuba.
La mujer en Cuba está con la pareja que ella decide.
A woman in Cuba goes with the companion whom she decides to have.
O sea, el jefe, vamos a suponer, que quisiera, por ofertar un puesto de trabajo, acosar a una mujer.
That is any leader or boss who wants to sexually harass a woman or demand sexual favors of a woman in order to give her a post.
Sabe que el peso de la ley caería sobre él.
Knows that the full weight of the law will fall upon him.
O sea, les digo responsablemente, nunca he oído un caso de acoso sexual en ningún medio de difusión masiva.
I can tell you truthfully, I've never heard of any case of this kind of sexual harassment in any of the mass communications media in Cuba.
Ni en la televisión, ni por la radio, ni en el periódico, ni personalmente.
Not by television, radio, or the newspapers, nor anybody that I know personally.
Les digo, puede que en algún momento algún aberrado, alguna persona, no sé, en una familia, algo lo haga, pero habrá sido, no sé, en alguna mujer o en alguna niña cercano a él, no sé, pero no es un problema social.
That is something could happen in there's a case, a situation where some man, perhaps in his family, does something to his wife or his children, but nothing on a broader level of society.
No obstante, nosotros tenemos en todos los municipios.
Nonetheless, we have in every municipality.
Una comisión que se llama Comisión de Atención a la Mujer y la Familia.
We have committees or commissions which are called the Commission for the Attention or for Aid to Women and the Family.
Que es un grupo multidisciplinario.
Which is a multidisciplinary group.
Compuesto por abogados, psicólogos, psiquiatras, médicos, ginecólogos.
Which is made up of lawyers, of doctors, of psychiatrists, of psychologists, of gynecologists.
Miembros de la Federación de Mujeres Cubanas.
Members of the Cuban Women's Federation.
Donde cualquier mujer tiene el derecho a ir, presentarse y plantear una queja.
Where every woman has the right to go there and raise any problem that she has.
Igual que nuestros tribunales de base, los tribunales municipales, también están abiertos a cualquier tipo de declaración de una mujer que se sienta acosada.
And also our municipal courts are open to any woman who has needs to raise any complaints about being sexually harassed.
Y les digo que la población no domina, yo me asombra mucho todos esos casos aquí.
And I have to tell you, I'm really shocked by what I see here in this country.
Porque no conozco de ningún caso, ni mucho menos así de que lleven años, porque oigo que hay informes que han dado mujeres de que hace años ya que las acosaron.
And much less anything that goes on for years, because here I understand that there are things that have happened years ago that women are just now reporting, that this can go on for years.
O sea, veo que es un fenómeno que está instaurado en este país, me da pena, desde hace bastante tiempo.
And it appears to me that this is a problem which is really deeply rooted in this country from way back. I'm sorry to say it, but that's how it appears to me.
Yo trabajé 31 años porque yo estoy jubilada.
I'm retired now, but I worked for 31 years.
Yo fui maestra, no ahora, que ya soy mayor.
I was a teacher, but not now. Now I'm older.
De joven, yo tuve aulas enteras, que era al revés que esto. Mis alumnos estaban más abajo y yo estaba en un estrado.
When I was younger and I was teaching, I had classrooms that were just the reverse of this. That is, the students were all on the lower level, and I was up on the platform, speaker's platform, in front of them.
Era joven, todos mis alumnos eran hombres.
I was young, all my students were men.
Porque fue durante un tiempo, unos cuantos años, daba clases a trabajadores en activo que estudiaban de noche.
Because for a good number of years, I was giving night classes to workers. They would work during the day and then come for night classes at night.
Era un politécnico.
This was a polytechnical institute.
Y yo salía, empezaba 5 de la tarde, terminaba 11 de la noche.
And I would go there at 5 o'clock in the afternoon, and I would not leave until 11 o'clock at night.
Yo sola, joven, vestida bien, y nunca tuve problemas con ninguno de mis alumnos, todo lo contrario.
So I was young, I was well-dressed, very presentable, and I never had any problem with any of my students.
Quiero decirles que yo vivía en un barrio que quizás se pudiera llamar marginal, en el sentido de que estaba apartado de la ciudad.
And I lived in a neighborhood that you could consider was remote or marginalized, in the sense that it was quite remotely removed from the center of the city.
Y mi esposo no iba ni a esperarme a la parada de la guagua.
And my husband wouldn't even go and wait for me at the bus stop.
Como él trabajaba tanto, me lo encontraba durmiendo.
And he worked so much that when I got home, I would find him asleep already.
Tranquilamente.
But everyone was very comfortable.
O sea, les digo que sinceramente, en todos mis años, y yo soy una persona activa aún después de jubilada.
And so I must tell you that, you know, in all the years I've seen, and I'm someone who continues to be active, even though I'm now retired.
Converso con muchas personas, y no he visto casos de acoso sexual como tal.
And I've talked to many, many people, and I've never seen cases of sexual harassment like these.
Quizás algún hombre separado de la esposa, y entonces, bueno, quiera seguir con ella. Entonces, se dan a veces algunas situaciones, pero es muy específico.
There could be something like, okay, a man breaks up with his wife, but he still wants to go out with her, and so you have a situation there, but just something very peculiar like that.
O sea, en mi país, le digo, no soy absoluta. Puede que pase en muy casuístico, pero no es un problema para la mujer cubana.
So I'm not saying that it never happens in Cuba. It could happen in Cuba, but really it's not a problem for Cuban women.
Si alguien tiene alguna duda, quiere preguntarme algo.
Anybody have any questions? Would like to ask me anything? Ellos vienen para poder hablar por la grabación.
In capitalist United States, there are a number of people in authority who have the ability to hire and fire us, to promote us, and they use that to demand sexual favors. Most of them in authority are men, to demand sexual favors of their employees or the person that they have the ability to hire and fire. Especially in Hollywood, where you can't get into the union for actors and actresses without being in the union, and you can't get in the union without experience. So these big shots in Hollywood use their position to sexually harass potential, you know, aspiring actors, actresses. Isn't it funny that none of these people who have been accused have demanded due process and have wanted to fight for their jobs or whatever in court, because they're afraid even more would come out.
Es impresionante que ninguno de los que han sido acusados ha reclamado su derecho de tener un juicio, un proceso judicial, o dicen que son inocentes. Y esto demuestra que ellos tienen temor de que haya aún más cosas peores que todavía no han salido a la luz.
Not one of them have gone to court to so-called get justice and get due process, because what's come out is just a tip of the iceberg. So. In Cuba, where the role of women is observed and practiced and not considered sex objects, but equals in work, sports, education, and so forth, this doesn't, and you don't have a capitalist system with the hierarchy and the ability of some to control the lives of others and decide whether they get the job or get the promotion. That's as I see it, the fundamental difference. And I'm glad that you brought this point up, because it's one of the things I think that the Cuban Revolution has accomplished, is taking the role of women and put it on an equal plane with men. Thank you.
La diferencia a mi punto de vista entre Estados Unidos y Cuba es que en Cuba no hay capitalismo, entonces no hay gente en posiciones así de poder para poder abusarlo contra otros. Y también porque la mujer se considera como un ser humano igual al hombre en el trabajo, en la vida, y por eso no da situaciones semejantes. Y me agradezco mucho a usted de haber venido acá para plantear esta cuestión a nosotros.
Yeah. Miren, por ejemplo, para que ustedes vean más cómo funcionan en Cuba las cuestiones. Por ejemplo, hay un jefe determinado y hay un puesto de trabajo que está vacante. Sencillamente vienen las personas, la mujer que opta por ese puesto de trabajo, no es específicamente ese jefe el que la entrevista, sino existe un departamento o un área de recursos humanos que es quien tiene los requisitos que tiene ese puesto de trabajo, entrevista a la persona que está optando por esto, esa persona aporta los documentos que avalan que puede ocupar el puesto, su currículum, su experiencia en el trabajo, y entonces se analiza en recursos humanos y se le explica a ese jefe. Y ya de acuerdo, las personas, eso es normal en mí, se me olvida.
So to give you an example, say there's a boss or a jefe, a leader,
supervisor
or manager, better, administrator in Cuba, uh-huh, who has a position that's open, needs to be filled. Well, he's not the one who does the interviewing. There'll be a committee or a human relations department that has all the information about the job positions, what the requirements are, and a woman who wants the job would go and put her application into that department. They would review her documentation, her experience, her work history, and so forth, and then they would inform the administrator that they have found a candidate who can take the job.
Y si esa persona cumple con los requisitos, sencillamente se incorpora a trabajar. Se encuentra 3 meses a prueba para ver si verdaderamente demuestra los conocimientos, cómo es su disciplina laboral, etc. Y al tiempo, o sea, los 3 meses, ya sencillamente, si no ha tenido ningún señalamiento, si demuestra sus conocimientos, queda fijo en la plaza.
And so a woman who can present documents and the experience necessary for the position gets it, and then you have 3 months, it's a trial period, where you show on the job that you really can do the job that you are hired to do, and after that 3 months, if there's no problems, then you get the job on a regular basis.
O sea, el criterio del jefe tiene que ver en cuanto a resultados de su trabajo, pero no es quien decide si la persona queda en ese puesto de trabajo.
So yes, the administrator official does have something to say about the results of the work that a person does, but that's not the person who decides whether or not a person gets to keep the position.
O sea, ninguna mujer ni hombre tiene que hacerle favores al jefe para poder ocupar ese puesto.
So neither women nor men have to do favors for their administrator or manager to be able to keep their position.
El contenido del jefe es dirigir el área que le tiene asignada y evaluar los resultados del trabajo de esa persona.
The responsibility of the administrator or the manager is to lead the work of the area he or she is responsible for, and to evaluate the work of the individuals who work in that area.
Pero existe en cada entidad, en cada empresa, en cada centro de trabajo, la representación del sindicato.
And in every workplace, In every enterprise, there is also union representatives.
Que ampara ante cualquier reclamación que haya que hacerle algún jefe.
And they support the workers in any demand that they have to raise against the administrators.
Que vuelvo y repito, nunca ha sido de acoso sexual.
And as I said before, it's never been cases of sexual harassment.
Los problemas que puede que se den sea con relación al resultado de su trabajo.
Where they could have disagreements or conflicts is in evaluating the results or how well someone is doing their job.
O sea, el jefe puede que opine que el resultado no es satisfactorio.
That is, the administrator might say that he or she thinks that the person is not doing a good job.
Y entonces existe, a nivel de base, está el sindicato y está, como decir, el órgano de justicia laboral.
But then there is within the enterprise both the union and what we call the labor justice organism.
Es como se llama, órgano de justicia laboral.
That's what it's called, the labor justice organ.
Que cuando existe algún tipo de problema entre el jefe y su subordinado, se puede plantear a ese nivel y se realizan las investigaciones pertinentes.
And so when there is this type of conflict between an administrator or manager and an employee, this conflict is taken to these bodies and they do an investigation and resolve it.
Pero eso es en lo laboral, porque les digo que de sexo no.
But this has to do with, you know, disputes over labor questions. Things have to do with sexual harassment or sexual violence, just, no, I haven't seen it.
Yeah.
Yes, so, ¿quieres tener en este momento cerrarlo o quieres más bien recoger algunas preguntas y luego continuar?
Sí, quiero contestarle lo que quieren saber.
So, yeah, there seems to be two questions, and I do have a question as well, so... Why don't we listen to her questions and then she will respond to those. So would you like to come over? And I want to take the opportunity to thank our wonderful translator. I will have, surprisingly, I have no objection to anything he has said.
No hemos terminado el trabajo todavía.
Perfect. I will not say the same about me, so please.
My question is this. For ever since the revolution was made, for almost 60 years, the United States government has carried out an economic war against Cuba. And, you know, cut off diplomatic relations. Well, now they have established some diplomatic relations, but they continue the economic war against Cuba. And they want to establish U.S. businesses in Cuba. They want to destroy the revolution from within instead of attacking it from outside. My understanding, and maybe you could explain this more, is that Cuba says, yes, you can set up businesses, you know, if you want to build a hotel, you can build a hotel in Cuba, but you have to operate it in the framework of Cuban labor laws. In the United States, women who work in hotels are super exploited and are targets of lots of sexual harassment. Women in general, I think the number now is women make 71% of what men make in the United States. But in Cuba, and they would like to carry out the same policy in Cuba, any U.S. businesses. But my understanding is Cuba says, no, you have to abide by our laws of equal pay, no sexual harassment, and so on. So could you say a few words about that?
Bien, Cuba está abierta a la inversión extranjera.
Cuba is open to foreign investment.
Nosotros tenemos inclusive una vez al año, generalmente en los primeros días de noviembre, Tenemos una feria muy grande que se realiza en Expo Cuba, que es un centro ferial, el más grande de Cuba.
And in fact, once a year, usually in the early part of November, we have a big fair, which is carried out in the Expo Cuba, which is a big exposition center in Cuba.
Donde van países de todos los continentes a proponer los negocios para realizarlos con Cuba.
Where people come from countries all around the world to make proposals for enterprises they would like to set up in Cuba.
Y de estas ferias han salido negocios provechosos para ambas partes cuando se ha establecido.
And out of this fair, we have had a number of joint enterprises established, which have been to the benefit of both parties.
Tenemos negocios con diferentes tipos de áreas, o sea, el área biotecnología, el área de salud en general, el área de industrial, el área de turismo.
We have had joint ventures in a number of areas, in biotechnology, in health, in industry, and in tourism.
Pero hay que cumplir con las normativas del Estado cubano.
But they must all comply with the Cuban rules and regulations.
Dentro de esto está el respeto a los logros que ha tenido la revolución.
This includes respect for the gains that have been won by the Cuban Revolution.
Con relación a salario, a igualdad de género, igualdad de raza.
In terms of salary, we get equal pay regardless of one's gender or one's race.
Y nosotros estaremos muy necesitados de que los extranjeros inviertan para poder mejorar nuestra economía.
And we do require that the foreign enterprises make investments that will improve our economy.
Pero nunca se va a negociar con los logros de la revolución.
But we're never going to negotiate on terms of giving up things which have been won through the revolution.
Y esa certeza la tiene el pueblo.
This is something that the people are sure of.
Por lo tanto, estamos amparados y nunca van a poder establecer diferentes salarios porque sea usted hombre, mujer o porque sea negro o blanco.
And that's why we are supported, and we know that they will never be able to impose different salaries on one person because they're a woman or because they're black.
Nunca se va a admitir que una persona por negra no puede ocupar un cargo.
Or they'll never be able to say that a woman, because she is black, cannot take a particular position.
Ya eso hace muchos años que en mi país no pasa.
It's been a long time in my country since that ever happened.
Ni va a pasar de nuevo porque es imposible que un pueblo involucione.
And
retroceda.
It's not going to happen in my country because it's impossible that a whole people would fall backwards in that way.
Ya nuestra conciencia está formada a cómo deben ser las cosas.
As we have a strong consciousness about how things should be.
Y todos estos logros y toda la sociedad cubana que es multiracial.
And all of these gains and all of the Cuban society, which is a multiracial society.
No va a cambiar sus costumbres en este sentido.
We're not going to change the customs that we now have along these lines.
Nosotros, de toda forma, porque yo pertenezco a la Sociedad Cubana de Psicología.
And I belong to the Cuban Society of Psychiatrists.
Específicamente en la sección de identidades y diversidad.
Specifically in their section that takes up identity and diversity.
Tratamos los temas de la homofobia, el racismo, la violencia contra la mujer.
We take up questions of homophobia, of racism, and of violence against women.
Y otros temas más. Y nosotros estamos pendientes de cualquier manifestación de ese tipo, porque bueno, puede surgir, nadie sabe.
And we're on the lookout for any manifestations of these types of prejudices or problems, because it's possible it could happen.
A Cuba está entrando mucho turismo.
Right now there are many tourists going to Cuba.
Y a veces los turistas vienen inclusive hombres mayores de edad.
And the tourists often include older men.
Vienen en busca de jóvenes bonitas, como las tenemos nosotros, porque la mujer cubana es bella.
And they come looking for beautiful young women, which we think of all of ourselves are, because Cuban women are beautiful.
Y el Estado está al tanto de esas cosas porque a veces eso sí pasa, ¿ve?
And the state is well aware of the situation because at times it does happen.
Pero no es realmente acoso, sino es que las propias jóvenes.
But it's not really sexual harassment because the young women themselves.
Como en Cuba hay tantos problemas económicos.
Because we have so many economic difficulties in Cuba.
Ven en este extranjero la solución a sus problemas.
They see that this foreign tourist is the solution to their problems.
O sea, ellas no están acosadas.
That is, they're not being harassed.
Si venimos a ver, a veces las mujeres son las que están detrás del extranjero.
And sometimes it's the women who are going after the foreign tourists.
Esto no es una cosa general, pero bueno, cuando ustedes van a Cuba y pueden ir en cualquier momento, puede que vean situaciones como esta.
This is not a general situation, but well, if you go to Cuba, and when you do go to Cuba, you will see things like this happening.
Pero quiero que sepan que eso está perseguido.
But this is something that is prosecuted.
O sea, el país, la sociedad, no está ajeno a estas cosas que pasan.
That a society is not unaware of these kind of things that are going on.
Son problemas sociales que han surgido producto de la globalización, del turismo, y entonces las jóvenes a veces no ven las cosas como deben, sino se deslumbran ante el primer mundo.
And these are problems that have come about because of the globalization of tourism, and in some cases there are young women that get kind of just startled or fantasize about facing the first world.
Nuestra sociedad no es perfecta. Ese es un problema que tenemos nosotros.
Our society is not perfect. This is a problem that we have.
Con el que se está trabajando.
And which we are working on.
No es que esas muchachas estén desvalidas, porque hay donde estudiar, hay para trabajar, pero buscan una vía fácil.
It's not that these women don't have alternatives, because they can go to school, they can work, but they're looking for an easy way out.
Y bueno, a veces son codiciadas por personas, hombres mayores, que hacen lo que no deben.
And yes, sometimes they are sought out by older male tourists who do what they shouldn't be doing.
Y entonces surgen parejas que se casan y todo, se casan y se van para el extranjero con su esposo.
And there are cases where the tourist and the young woman marry, and then she leaves and goes with her husband to the foreign country.
Resuelven sus problemas económicos, pero realmente como personas es bastante lo que pierden.
This may satisfy her economic needs, but you got to think about all that she's losing in the process.
Eso estamos conscientes que está pasando. No les digo, no es la mayoría, pero pasa. Y es una situación que tenemos en la sociedad cubana.
This is something that we know that's going on. It's not most people, it's not the majority, but it is a situation that's going on. It's a situation that we're facing.
En determinados casos, porque bueno, estamos enfrascados en mejorar en muchas cosas, pero eso es un detalle que tenemos que seguir trabajando en él.
Because we're trying to work on improving many problems that we have, and this is certainly one of the details that we do have to keep working on.
Y ustedes, el que va a Cuba, lo percibe, lo ve, no es algo que no se vea, se ve.
And when you go to Cuba, you will see this kind of thing going on.
Pero les decía, no es una sociedad perfecta, estamos recuperando valores, estamos trabajando con los jóvenes también, y bueno, es una sociedad que está avanzando indiscutiblemente, y que tiene grandes logros comparados con países que aparentemente lo tienen todo.
And we're still a country that's with problems that we're working on, including we're working with young people, trying to develop their values, but we're a country that has tremendous gains already, including when you compare many of our situations with much more developed countries.
Eso es en general.
So that's the general answer.
¿Alguna otra duda?
Other questions? Yeah.
Sí, habían dos preguntas. So I think you were first. I'm sorry. Okay. Sam first, and then the gentleman on the back, and then I have a question as well. But let's hear you.
Can you go into a little particular cases of domestic violence and family violence against children?
Hablarnos de casos particulares de violencia familiar o violencia doméstica.
And what recourse do women have to, the wives or girlfriends have to defend themselves and take action to defend themselves, like getting protection orders, so people, the man has to stay away, or I know cases of family violence where the husband beats up the wife, but the wife doesn't have a job, so she's not going to get one, so she stays there.
Entonces, ¿cuáles son las avenidas abiertas a las mujeres en una situación tal para buscar, para reclamar, para defenderse? O sea, hay medidas legales o existe el caso de que la mujer no tiene empleo y el hombre sí tiene empleo, entonces la mujer no puede salir de la situación por falta de empleo.
And I've read here that there's more shelters for dogs than there are for women. Like, so if you wanted to leave, women here don't have a place to go. So if a woman in Cuba was getting beaten up by her husband, where could she go and how could she stop him from being around her?
Así que yo creo que en Estados Unidos hay más albergues para perros y gatos que para mujeres que sufren violencia. Entonces muchas mujeres no tienen donde ir, si están en una situación de violencia familiar. Entonces en Cuba, ¿dónde pueden ir a recurrir una mujer en una situación así?
And I know it's still accepted here that parents can beat their own children, even though other adults are not allowed to. That's illegal. I don't know what are the laws in Cuba about parental violence against children, because physical violence, well, I mean, it's all physical violence to different degrees, even like spanking and so on. What kind of laws does Cuba have about parental violence against their children, and like at what level do they say this is violent, but under this level this is not violent and this is okay to hit your children like this?
Es que en Estados Unidos se es aceptable que los padres castiguen a sus hijos golpeándolos. No es aceptable que otro adulto golpee a un niño, pero los padres sí lo pueden hacer. Entonces pregunta en Cuba cuál es la situación, hay leyes respecto a violencia o castigos contra los niños, los hijos de uno, ¿cuál es la situación?
Bien, con relación a la violencia, también estamos trabajando en eso. Existe violencia fundamentalmente doméstica. Los casos que hay son de violencia doméstica. Parejas que tienen situaciones y llegan de determinados grados de violencia.
Yes, we do have situations of violence, domestic violence really primarily, where you have a couple that have conflicts and it reaches a certain level of violence. This is something that we're working on.
En este caso, les hablé ya ahorita de la casa de atención a la mujer y la familia. Ese es un lugar donde la mujer puede ir en cuanto se siente agredida.
And I already spoke about these home for attention of women and children. In every municipality, that's where a woman can go whenever she feels she has a problem of this sort.
Estas casas existen en el país entero, o sea, cualquier mujer de cualquier lugar del país tiene acceso a ese lugar, y eso se divulga para que las mujeres sepan dónde tienen que dirigirse cuando se sienten violentadas.
These centers exist all across the country, and there are so many of them that they are accessible to all women throughout Cuba, and they're publicized, so that a woman would know where she can go if she finds herself in this kind of situation.
Además, la población cubana es una población muy atendida en el aspecto de la salud. Nosotros tenemos médicos de familia que están ahí al alcance de nosotros, o sea, en los alrededores de nuestra casa.
And the Cuban people are also very well taken care of in terms of health care, that we have family doctors in every neighborhood. You have a doctor who's right there, very close to where everybody lives.
Y ante cualquier situación que haya, esa es otra persona a la que la mujer puede ir a exponer su situación.
And this is another person to whom any woman can go to raise the problem she's having.
Ante cualquier tipo de agresión, contamos con el médico de la familia, con el policlínico y con cualquier hospital.
And you also have the family doctor, you have the polyclinics, and you have the nearby hospital also.
Y cuando la mujer plantea que ha sido golpeada o que ha sido vejada o que ha sido algo, tiene también los tribunales municipales.
And when a woman has been hit or beaten, you also have the municipal courts.
Si ha sido agredida físicamente en estos policlínicos y en los hospitales, existen policías también que están allí, que trabajan ante cualquier situación, y se levanta un acta dada por el médico con las lesiones relacionadas en ese certificado.
And if a woman has been physically attacked in the polyclinics and the hospitals, there are actually police stations, and there the doctors will prepare a report detailing the specific injuries that she suffered, so it can be taken to the courts.
Y ese certificado sirve como documento oficial para procesar, o sea, para llevar a tribunales a la persona que va a ser enjuiciada.
And this documentation then is sufficient to initiate court proceedings against the individual who's accused of doing it.
Quiero que sepan que la ley, en este caso, respalda mucho a la mujer y a la niña ante cualquier tipo de situación, y hay hombres que han sido violentos y automáticamente son recluidos y no se les permite ni siquiera fianza para que no vuelvan a salir y le puedan agredir de nuevo.
And the laws in Cuba actually are very favorable for women on these questions, women and young children. And there are men who have carried out violence like this who have been actually locked up, imprisoned, and not let out even on bail so that they cannot repeat the kind of, these kind of attacks.
Y existen el Código Penal establecido de acuerdo a la falta lo que le corresponde por violar algo tan sagrado como la vida de la mujer y la niña.
And there are specific articles in the penal code for anyone who violates such a sacred element as the life of a woman or a child.
Yo conozco inclusive un caso que cumplió 30 años de prisión porque asesinó a la esposa.
I know one case of a man who was condemned to 30 years of prison because he murdered his wife.
Y la esposa le estaba siendo infiel con otro hombre.
And the woman actually was having an affair with another man.
Y él la sorprendió.
And he surprised them.
Pero eso no es atenuante para nada. Nadie tiene derecho a violentar a nadie, mucho menos una mujer.
But this is not extenuating circumstances at all. Nobody has any right to rape a woman under any circumstances.
O sea, es muy delicado este tema en Cuba y es muy perseguido.
So this is a very delicate question in Cuba, but one that's given a lot of attention.
Ante cualquier queja. Y se crea toda una investigación y vienen al lugar de residencia para ver cómo se ha manifestado esa persona, si es verdad que ha sido violento, si es la primera vez, si es reincidente.
But any complaint along these lines is taken very seriously, and a thorough investigation is carried out, including going to the person's home to see if there's any evidence, what the situation has been, if it has happened before.
O sea, esto está muy definido bien por la ley.
This is all spelled out by law.
Con relación a los niños.
In terms of children.
En Cuba, como en cualquier lugar, puede que se dé, quizás, no sé, algún caso de que alguna madre o un padre le den, no sé, a un hijo, unas nalgadas, un problema, pero bueno, nunca es algo que afecte al niño, como yo veo cosas aquí también.
In terms of children, it's true that there are situations where a mother or a father may spank their child, but it never gets to the point that it really physically affects them as badly as cases that I've seen in this country.
Los padres cubanos son más bien, somos protectores.
Cuban parents are very much protective.
Al punto que nuestros hijos crecen, se casan, y nosotros seguimos al tanto de nuestros hijos.
To the point that our children grow up, they get married, and we're still closely following their lives.
Y así mismo estamos al tanto de los nietos.
And we're very aware of the situation of our grandchildren.
O sea, que no existen eso que yo vi aquí, un caso hace unos días que lo vi en Miami, de que le quemó las manos a un niño, su propia mamá.
And I've seen nothing ever happen like what I just saw reported in Miami just a few days ago, that a mother actually burned the hands of her child.
Yo no entiendo. Vi un juicio de una también que mató a su niño hace unos años y le estaban celebrando el juicio hace unos días atrás.
I saw also recently a news report of a trial of a woman who had killed her child. I guess she killed her some years ago, but the trial was just carried out now.
Esas cosas realmente no, nunca en la vida se han visto así.
These are things that I've never seen in Cuba.
Y además de eso, bueno, los vecinos, el cubano es muy de relacionarse con sus vecinos y sabemos todo lo que pasa. No es como aquí, que yo veo que las personas viven cada uno en sus casas y prácticamente no se ven, no se saludan, Cuba no es así.
And also, Cubans live very much involved with their neighbors. You kind of live in everybody's house. It's not like what I see here, where people just live in their own house and don't even know who's living next door, but Cubans know each other and they know what's going on in great detail in every family.
Yo vivo, por ejemplo, en un apartamento, en un edificio de 30 apartamentos, y todos sabemos cómo son los padres con los niños, si son padres bien atendidos, o sea, todo esto. Y la Federación de Mujeres Cubanas trata estos temas cuando hay, por ejemplo, alguna mamá soltera que deja el niño por necesidad o algo en la casa, y el nené se tiene que, nené no, más grande, calentarse su comida o algo así, y nos ayudamos con los que estamos ahí en las casas, ya los que estamos jubilados.
For instance, I live in an apartment building with 30 apartments, and everybody knows all the families and what the situation is with every family in that building. And there's also, we have the Federation of Cuban Women, which pays attention to different families. And if there's a situation like a single mother, say, who maybe finds she has to leave her child to go off and do something, well, then the Federation tries to get help to make sure the child has some attention or someone cooks a meal for them or whatever type of help they need.
O sea, nuestros niños no son maltratados por los padres, al contrario.
Our children are not mistreated by their parents, just the opposite.
Más bien los sobreprotegemos un poco, porque yo tengo uno de 47 años y otro de 40, y se quejan de que todavía el padre y yo estamos ahí al tanto de qué hiciste, mira cómo viniste, cuídate, ten cuidado, si está lloviendo, llévate la capa, no sé.
In fact, maybe we're a little bit overprotective. I have a child who's 47, another one who's 40, and they keep telling me, you know, I'm there all the time. Don't worry about me. Don't keep watching over me, but I'm there. Oh, it's going to rain. It's going to rain. Be sure you take your raincoat.
Y ya comiste. No has comido. Ven, siéntate y come. Eso es así.
Did you eat? Did you eat? Sit down. Eat something.
Eso es así.
That's the way we are.
Así que en mí, allá no hay violencia tampoco así contra los niños. Al contrario.
It just really isn't that kind of violence against children.
Y además en la escuela se le enseña a los niños en la primaria los derechos que tienen los niños.
And also in the schools, beginning in the very first primary grades, children are taught what they call the rights of the child.
El derecho a ser escuchados por los padres.
The right to be heard by your parents.
El derecho a jugar, el derecho a los estudios, el derecho a la salud.
The right to play, the right to study, the right to have health care.
Los niños en Cuba saben bien los derechos que ellos tienen.
Cuban children know very well the list of rights that they have.
Además, ellos tienen, por ejemplo, de primero a sexto grado, tienen la Organización de Pioneros de Cuba.
And those who are in the first to the sixth grade have their own organization, the Pioneers Organization of Cuba.
Que funciona en las escuelas y tienen murales donde están, ustedes van a cualquier escuela en Cuba y ahí aparecen los derechos de los niños.
And they have displays, bulletin boards in all of the schools. You can go to any school in Cuba and you will see up on one of these bulletin boards the whole display of the list of the rights of the child.
O sea, ellos dominan a que tienen derecho.
So they know that they have rights.
El niño cubano es muy avispado.
The Cuban children are
muy
very
despierto.
Much supportive. They're very awake, very aware. Mm-hmm.
Thank you. Gentleman on the back.
Yes, I'm a Pan-Africanist, and first I wanted to give thanks to Cuba for the revolutionary support of Africa, Angola in particular. I'd also want to give thanks to Cuba for exile for our revolutionary sister, Asada Shakur. My understanding that I've come to learn is that the political maturity is a reflection of the political maturity of the women of the country. And women often are the guardians and the vanguard of the revolution and the keepers of the revolution. They are our first teachers. What can we do as men to support our sisters, our revolutionary sisters. What can we do to support our international struggles, to support Cuba, to support Guatemala, to support Venezuela, Colombia, Chiapas, all these places that we have similar things in common. And just want to know, how can we be of assistance and also supporting our women's struggle in the revolutionary to keep it vibrant, to keep it alive? Thank you. Viva Cuba.
Thank you so much for your question.
Bueno, a la mujer, hay muchas formas de apoyarla, la mujer cubana. Nosotros estamos agredidos por el bloqueo. Eso nos afecta a la nación entera.
There are many ways to help the Cuban women. We are all affected by the economic blockade. The entire nation is affected by it.
Nosotros tenemos muchas carencias que no tuviéramos si dispusiéramos del dinero que se gasta trayendo productos de lugares más lejanos, producto del bloqueo.
We have many shortages, many of which we would not have if we didn't have to spend so much of our resources bringing products from much further away than we would have to if we didn't have to deal with this economic blockade.
Hay muchas madres que tienen hijos enfermos, por ejemplo, de cáncer y de diferentes enfermedades.
There are many, many mothers, for instance, who have children who are sick with cancer and other diseases.
Y ustedes tienen aquí, en este país tan maravilloso y tan desarrollado.
And in this very well-developed country here, you have things.
Tienen medicamentos que pudieran utilizarse en esos niños.
You have medications that we could be using to help save these children.
Sin embargo, tenemos que invertir una cantidad de dinero extraordinario para poder traer esos medicamentos de otros lugares.
But we have to spend a huge amount of money instead to bring this medication from other parts of the world.
Claro, eso también nos ha desarrollado porque hemos tenido que ser autosuficientes en muchas cosas.
Of course, this is something that we have also developed because we have had to become self-sufficient in many things.
Y eso ha hecho que el país se desarrolle, por ejemplo, en la parte biotecnológica, en toda una serie de medicamentos para poder solventar nosotros mismos nuestras propias dificultades.
And this has led us in our biotechnical industry to develop many medications that we have had to develop so that we could supply ourselves with the needed medications.
Uh-huh. O sea, ese es el aspecto más sensible que yo veo, porque realmente los cubanos en general estamos afectados por muchas cosas, pero la mujer indiscutiblemente es fuerte, pero en ocasiones pasamos mucho trabajo para resolver cosas porque no tenemos los recursos.
This question, the economic blockade, is the biggest thing that I think you can do to help us, because we're strong, the Cuban women are strong, but Cuban women do have to go through an awful lot of effort and trouble because we simply don't have the resources that we should have.
O sea, creo que el primer eslabón sería, para poder salir de este problema, sería la eliminación del bloqueo.
So I think the first step would be to eliminate the economic blockade, to get rid of this problem.
La unidad entre los países y los pueblos.
Then there's unity between peoples and the countries.
Entre las mujeres propiamente de las naciones.
Between women of different countries.
Unirnos y ser más fuertes cada vez.
To unite ourselves and become stronger at the same time.
Independientemente de las disposiciones que tengan nuestros gobiernos.
Regardless of whatever the positions or thinking of our governments are.
Creo que eso es lo que puede cambiar la situación de la mujer, tanto de nosotros mejorarnos allá económicamente, como aquí, con toda esta parte espiritual, si se quiere, que es tan importante para la mujer.
This could help all women everywhere, including those of us in Cuba, in terms of our economic situation, and for women here in terms of, well, what I would call the spiritual dimension, which is
porque
so much
tienen
needed.
Quizás muchas cosas materiales, pero falta esa otra parte que es el sostén del ser humano.
Because you have many material goods here, but you're missing this part, which really is the support of the human being.
Y en lo reducido en la familia, los hombres son muy importantes en la cooperación con la mujer, con la esposa, con la madre.
And in terms of the family, men have a very important role in helping out their wives and helping out their mothers.
Nosotros tenemos una consigna que cuando un hombre participa en los trabajos de la casa, antes se decía, mi esposo me ayuda.
And we have a saying in Cuba, it used to be the case that when a man would help out around the house, they would say, my husband helps me in the house.
Ya la mujer cubana cambió el verbo.
Now the Cuban women have changed the verb.
Ahora decimos, el hombre comparte los quehaceres de la casa.
Now we say, the man shares what has to be done in the house.
No me ayuda porque yo no soy la dueña de la casa. Yo no tengo por qué ser la responsable de todo en la casa.
He doesn't help me because I'm not the one who's in charge of the whole house. I'm not responsible for everything that goes on in the house.
No es una ayuda lo que da. Es una obligación.
It's not aid or assistance he's giving me. It's an obligation.
Debe compartir con la esposa.
He must share with his wife.
Los quehaceres de la casa.
All the tasks, household tasks.
Y si la esposa está estudiando, él debe cuidar los niños.
And if the wife is studying, he better take care of the children.
Y entonces, cuando viene el tiempo de descanso, entonces se puede pasear.
And then when you finally get to time for a break, then you can go out and take a walk.
O sea, el hombre en la sociedad cubana anterior no hacía prácticamente nada en la casa.
In the old Cuban society, men did virtually nothing within the house.
Era todo responsabilidad de la mujer. Ya no es así.
It was all the responsibility of the woman, of the wife, but now it's not that way.
Ahora es algo compartido.
Now it is something that they share.
Y los logros de la familia es de los dos.
And the achievements of the family are achievements of both of them.
Por eso es que se deben apoyar.
And that's why they should support each other.
Yeah.
Yeah, thank you so much. We have a question on the back as well.
So Harvey, I'm going to give you a break for a minute.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Dr. Howard Ehrman. I'm a semi-retired faculty member at the University of Illinois Chicago in the School of Public Health, College of Medicine. And I was the Assistant Commissioner of Health here in Chicago when Mayor Washington was alive. So my question is some of the most important aspects of women and women's health. In the United States, as many of you may know, the disappearance of Native American women, which is often directly part of the murder of Native American women, primarily by white men coming from off the reservation, is not even recorded in U.S. statistics.
Quiero decir que aquí en Estados Unidos es muy importante primero entender los datos. Y los datos, por ejemplo, de la gente indígena, las mujeres indígenas, que la mayoría de los asesinatos son de hombres blancos que no son parte de sus propias reservaciones. Mm. Que trabajen en como petróleo, que trabajen en ranchos grandes. Estos datos no existen hasta este momento aquí en Estados Unidos.
The other situation that we have in the United States since 1990 is that the maternal deaths per 100,000 births have gone from 12 to 28. The greatest rise, again, has been among Native American and African American women. But this rise has been across all demographics, primarily women of color who are working class and poor. At the same time in Cuba, the maternal death rate has decreased from 58 to 39 and is continuing in that direction, whereas ours, even since 2015, continues to increase. So my question is basically about the situation of women in Cuba regarding their health when they're pregnant, before they're pregnant, and also their access to family planning, which is part of the problem that we have in the United States with maternal deaths, because access to family planning, particularly for poor working class women, has been significantly decreasing over the last 25 years. And the other aspect to this, in terms of what we call maternal morbidity and mortality, which means severe illness and or death, is the question of racism. Tomorrow at the University of Illinois, we're going to be having a session with Dr. Richard David, who is a neonatologist who, along with a physician here at Northwestern, a couple blocks away, and other physicians in the U.S. have documented the role that racism plays, particularly for African American women and Native American women, for their deaths, for their illnesses, and for having children prematurely. So that's another part of the question.
También queremos hablar para entender la situación de maternidad, de acceso a planificación familiar en Cuba, pero también aquí el papel del racismo. Mañana en la Universidad de Illinois vamos a tener un seminario donde un doctor especialista
neonatólogo
sí, va a hablar sobre los factores que ya podemos medir de racismo y cómo está afectando la mujer y su bebé. Y es la razón principal probablemente porque tantos bebés aquí son prematuros. Gracias.
Thank you so much for your question.
Sure.
Bueno, quiero tocar una pequeña cosita para que ustedes conozcan con relación a este tema que ha planteado el compañero. Yo quiero...
I want to say one thing so that you'll understand a bit about the question that the compañero was raising.
Quiero que ustedes sepan que en mi país existen, como en todos los lugares, algunos embarazos que son de riesgo.
In my country, as in all countries, there are certain pregnancies that are at risk or dangerous pregnancies.
De riesgo porque, por ejemplo, son mujeres que ya tienen una edad determinada, un poquito avanzada, o tienen menos de la edad que deben tener normalmente.
It could be because the woman either is rather old for bearing children or because it's a very young woman still.
O son mujeres diabéticas, hipertensas, cardiópatas, etc.
Or women who have diabetes or hypertension or other problems like that.
Y existen también en todos los municipios hogares maternos.
And in every municipality there is a maternity home.
Donde esas mujeres, cuando son captadas en su médico de familia,
and when the local family doctor realizes that these women are pregnant,
captadas quiere decir cuando van al médico y plantean que están embarazadas.
That is, when the woman goes to the doctor and tells the doctor that she is pregnant, this is someone who is at risk.
En todos los casos, una mujer está embarazada, va al médico, y si va a tener, o sea, si va a desarrollar su embarazo, se le inicia todo un historial.
And so when a woman goes to tell her doctor that she's pregnant, and if she wants to carry the pregnancy to term, then you begin a whole process of tracking the pregnancy.
Con una serie de investigaciones profundas.
With a whole series of medical, of very deep, thorough medical investigations.
Y si le da algún tipo de problema, esa mujer va para el hogar materno.
And if any problems are found, then the woman goes to the maternity home.
Allá se logra mucho llevar partos a término por esta situación.
And that's where they have a great deal of success in carrying pregnancies to a term, despite all the problems that they may have had.
O sea, esa mujer va para ese hogar materno y allí está atendida por médicos, enfermeras, personal especializado.
So the women that go to the maternity homes, there they're taken care of by doctors, by nurses, and other specialized personnel.
Controlada y chequeada para tratar de que siempre el embarazo llegue a su final.
That is, they are constantly watched and checked to make sure that the pregnancy can be carried to term successfully.
O sea, hay una atención especial con la mujer embarazada, gestante, y cuando ese bebé nace, tiene una atención óptima.
And so there's a great deal of attention paid to the woman while she is pregnant, and then when the baby is born in optimal conditions.
No sé si ustedes saben que el índice de mortalidad infantil en mi país es similar y más bajo en ocasiones que los países del primer mundo.
I don't know if you know it, but the infant mortality rate in my country is similar to or even lower than the rate in many of the most advanced countries in the world.
Y en el caso de la mujer, cuando tiene un hijo, se le da un año de licencia de maternidad.
And when a woman has a child, she's given 1 year's maternity leave.
O sea, durante ese primer año del niño, la mujer recibe su salario para que pueda lactar a ese niño, lo pueda atender, hasta que después lo pueda llevar a un círculo infantil.
So for the whole year after the child is born, the woman continues to receive her salary, but she's able to stay home and breastfeed the child, take care of the child, and then after a year, it's able to go into an infant child care center.
Y las administraciones pueden contratar alguna persona por esa persona, que por esa mujer que tuvo su niño, pero no pueden ocupar su puesto de trabajo.
And the administrator at whatever company the woman worked at, they can hire someone to replace her while she's on maternity leave, but they can't replace her and take the job away from her when she wants to come back.
O sea, la mujer tiene derecho a un año de licencia de maternidad pagada y a tres meses si es que tiene algún tipo de problema para buscar quien le cuide el niño, 3 meses entonces de licencia sin sueldo.
So she has both a 1 year maternity leave that is paid, and then if she has problems finding someone to take care of the child, she has an additional 3 months to try and resolve that problem, and while she still has the right to return to her job.
Y repito, sin que se pueda ocupar su puesto de trabajo.
And during all this time, no one else can take her job and keep it from her.
Así que eso es para darle la atención a ese niño y para que ella misma se reponga después de su parto.
And so this is both so that the child receives the necessary attention and so that the woman gets fully recovered from the experience of giving birth.
Reciben dietas especiales, tanto la mamá como el niño, de alimentación.
They also receive special food supplies, both the mother and the child.
O sea, para reforzar su alimentación y que el niño pueda tener un feliz desarrollo.
It is to improve their food so that they have a normal and healthy development.
Yeah.
Thank you so much, everybody, for all your questions and your participation. I know that everybody is quite... ¿quiere? Permitirle?
Sí, cómo no.
I withdraw what I was saying. I did not say nothing. There is a very active audience today. Griselda was asking me, what is the time? But let's hear the question.
Okay. I'll be quick.
No importa.
I want to thank
me alegra.
I want to thank you so much for being here. I really enjoyed listening to you speak. I'm going to Cuba on Thursday with my college, and I wanted to know first maybe what to expect as a tourist, but I've also had friends who have brought supplies with them or things that they know are hard to get in Cuba, like guitar strings or something like that. And so I wanted to know if you had any recommendations of things I could bring with me.
Thank you so much.
Bueno, en esta pregunta yo no sé exactamente qué respuesta les pueda dar. No sé si Howard sabrás algo de algún tipo de donación donde pudieran entregarla en Cuba, donde.
I don't know exactly what to tell you there. I don't know, maybe Howard knows of some organization that could receive a donation there, something particular you could take.
Sí, sí.
So I would say, I know you have a big heart as well as a great mind, but actually, the Cubans kind of discourage individuals.
Sé que los cubanos no quieren tanto que individuos lleven algo a donar a otro individuo. Prefieren que lo hagan a través de.
Well, I can say your people can always use batteries.
Okay. Dice que siempre se puede traer pilas. Siempre se necesitan pilas.
Incredibly expensive because of the blockade.
So we can't
take it. And those are easy to carry and incredibly important.
Yeah. De eso sí yo no sabía nada.
That's something I don't know anything about.
Well, this young lady has inspired me because I had a couple of questions I was not going to ask, but Griselda seems to be quite enjoying all this conversation. So I'm going to ask the question both in English and Spanish. It takes us a little bit back to some things that Griselda was saying before. So I am Colombian, and I am also a professor in the United States. And I'm quite familiar with sexual harassment both here and in Colombia. So I was paying close attention to your explanation about why there is no sexual harassment in Cuba. And I have maybe a couple of interconnected questions. One is, what is the situation of sexual harassment in the film industry and entertainment industries, which seem to be in the United States some of the industries where that is more rampant, versus just regular businesses, as well as in the media, if you have information about that. Paro para decirle, estoy hablando de mi experiencia como colombiana y como profesora en Estados Unidos con respecto al acoso sexual, y le preguntaba cuál es su experiencia o qué sabe usted sobre el acoso sexual en Cuba en las zonas de entretenimiento, o sea, en las áreas como el cine y como los medios de comunicación, que es donde aquí se presenta más el acoso sexual, porque son lugares donde, por ejemplo, en el cine, el director tiene una relación muy peculiar con sus actores, con el quien escribe los guiones y toda esta serie de condiciones que son distintas a las de un empleo de otro tipo. Esa es mi primera pregunta.
Ahorita dije que a mí no me ha llegado nunca. Yo no estoy en ese medio, pero no me ha llegado ningún tipo de situación, no ha llegado por ningún medio de comunicación masiva. Y nuestras artistas, nuestras profesionales del arte en general, son personas muy, muy bien definidas en lo que quieren, en su actitud, y no pienso que algún director de alguna película o algo pueda interferir en esto, porque también en esa rama existen las personas de recursos humanos, existen, no, a mí no ha llegado jamás nada.
Well, I'm not in that field, that is entertainment field, but I don't know of, I've never heard of or seen anything in the mass communications media, any report of sexual harassment situations like that. And I think that in Cuba, our actors and other performers, they are very confident in themselves and know what they want, and it's just not a situation where some director could carry out the kind of activity. And if they did, then in entertainment, as well as in other areas of the economy, there are the commissions of human resources, places one can go and file a complaint and get an investigation.
Conozco de ese medio artistas muy buenas que se han casado con directores de película, ¿no? Pero inclusive han sido matrimonios, por ejemplo, la esposa de Titón, no sé si ustedes la conocerán, y otras más. Muy buenas artistas casadas con directores y que han vivido, han sido matrimonios inclusive duraderos. Así que, no sé, no ha habido ningún tipo de...
So I know the cases, yes, where actresses have married directors and they've been very long-lasting marriages, and I just don't know of any cases where there were problems of this type.
Thank you so much for that answer. The second part of the question had to do with Colombia and my experience in Colombia. You pointed out that there is not so much of a chance of harassment when the supervisor or manager is not the one hiring, number one, and number two, when there is a union. Now, I'm Colombian, and I am a professor, and I was hired in Colombia never by a manager or supervisor, because this is not how it works in academia. It was a committee which considered the qualifications of people at the national level, one, and two, we have a union. I was in a public university, so those two conditions were met there. However, sexual harassment is rampant at every possible level, with students, among colleagues, from the president all the way down to students. So it's neither the fact that supervisors, in an academic setting, supervisors never hire, and two, there is a union. So what is the difference? Why is there a situation in which, with those same conditions, there is sexual harassment in one place, and apparently no sexual harassment on the other place? Entonces, estaba comentando que usted había mencionado que dos razones por las que no hay acoso sexual es que los supervisores o los jefes no son los que van a reclutar a la gente, sino uh-huh. que hay un grupo,
un departamento
de empleados.
Recursos humanos.
Y dos, que hay sindicatos. Entonces, esas dos cosas previenen el acoso. Entonces, estaba comentando que en Colombia, como profesora en la universidad, yo nunca fui, cuando fui contratada, no me contrató un jefe, sino un grupo, igual acá,
claro.
Y hay un sindicato.
Claro.
Sin embargo, el acoso sexual se vive a cada nivel de la universidad. ¿Cuál es la diferencia? I may add this, which is something that I wanted to add to the situation. We also say that it doesn't exist. So the fact that we don't talk about it does not mean that it doesn't exist. It means that we don't talk about it. So my point is, in the United States also, during decades, we have been pretending that there is no sexual harassment. So my question is, it doesn't exist because we don't talk about it, We don't talk about it because it doesn't exist, which is which. Entonces, agrego que también, a pesar que hay tanto acoso sexual en la universidad y en todo lugar en la sociedad, nosotros decimos que no hay acoso sexual y no hay leyes que protejan a las mujeres. Entonces, me pregunto si es que en Cuba no existe o no se habla de él en los medios. Porque igual en los Estados Unidos hemos pasado décadas sin hablar del acoso sexual y ahora nos estamos dando cuenta que ha sido epidémico. Pero durante mucho tiempo hemos dicho que no existe. Entonces, ¿cuál es cuál? No existe y no hablamos porque no existe, claro. O no hablamos y sí existe, pero no hablamos.
Claro. Bueno, en este caso yo les digo lo que yo sé. A mí nunca me ha llegado ninguna referencia de acoso sexual.
I can tell you just what I've seen, which is that I have never come across any occurrence of sexual harassment.
He sido una persona activa desde siempre en centros de trabajo, en centros de estudio, y nunca he oído un acoso sexual así manifiesto que yo haya sabido.
And I've been active all my life in workplaces, in schools, in teaching, and I have never come across or heard of any case of sexual harassment like this. Nothing that I've ever seen.
Y les digo porque soy mujer y soy cubana. Y no concibo yo oigo aquí el acoso sexual y entonces las mujeres. Yo eso en las cubanas, les digo realmente que yo no me lo puedo imaginar que un jefe le ponga como norma o como exigencia a una mujer cubana que esté con él para poderle dar el puesto de trabajo. Porque es que la mujer cubana sabe que si tiene derecho a ese puesto, porque tiene el conocimiento y lo puede demostrar, no tiene por qué entregársele a un hombre para poder ocupar un puesto de trabajo. Si eso es aquí o en determinados países, en mi país no pasa. En mi país, sí, ya.
And I would say as a woman, as a Cuban woman, that I just cannot imagine that this happens because Cuban women know what their rights are. And they know that they have a right to a position if they're qualified for it. And so the idea that any manager or administrator would demand that a woman sleep with him in order to get a job is just, I cannot imagine it. The woman wouldn't accept it because she knows she has a right to it. Maybe in other countries it's different, but Cuban women have a different understanding, a different consciousness.
No sé si las mujeres estas que han sido acosadas no han tenido verdaderamente, no sé, la calificación y no les ha quedado más remedio a las pobres que al fin y al cabo utilizar ese método, han sido utilizadas y entonces no les ha quedado más remedio que hacerlo. Pero en Cuba no es así.
I don't know if the situation was that there were women who really didn't have the qualifications and so they used their bodies as a way to get into a position or not. I just don't know. But in Cuba, it's not that way.
Yeah, I'd like to, from an outsider's point of view, give a little reason to answer your question.
I've been to Cuba several times and started working in solidarity in 1966. I think the primary reason and the primary difference, and this is not to say that there aren't individual cases of sexual harassment, is that Cuba had a socialist revolution in 1959, a socialist revolution that was led by dozens and dozens of women, including women guerrilla fighters, from almost the beginning. The situation in Cuba now is that in terms of the Communist Party, in terms of the People's Assembly, in every level, all the way up to the top, women, in many ways, in terms of professors in the university, are actually overrepresented in the population. In other words, more than 50% of many of these different demographics are occupied by women, including black women. This is not to say there still isn't things that Cuba has to do, but this is the primary reason in terms of the difference that that exists. And I'd like to give an example. Once I just go to make an announcement that Stan did at the beginning. We're having a very important forum on the Chicago Cuba Coalition in conjunction with the Women of Englewood and the University of Illinois at Chicago on Saturday at 10:30, which everyone's invited to at Teamwork Englewood, which is 815 West 63rd Street on the second floor of U.S. Bank, to talk about the first time in history that Cubans have been allowed to work in the United States. There are three physicians, two of whom are women, one of whom is a male, who are coming from the Ministry of Public Health, National Ministry of Public Health of Cuba. One other woman who's a nurse specialist in women in infant prevention. And this is about a project that started this year in Englewood to reduce infant mortality and improve the health of women. In Cuba, as the compañera mentioned, the infant mortality rate is 4 per 1,000 live births. In the United States, it's 6, so it's 50% higher. In Chicago as a whole, it's 7, but in Englewood, it's 13. Okay. And Englewood has historically, for the last 45 years, had one of the highest mortality rates of infants in the entire United States. So this is a project to begin to work directly with women to figure out how to deal with this situation. So if you're interested in that, or you can spread the word, I have a business card I can give you, and I can send you the flyer or whatever. But there's also an incredible phenomenon that is now happening in Cuba, which is directly related to everything that Griselda has said. For the first time in history, Cuba has actually begun in the last year or two to actually begin to go into negative population growth. And so the reason this is happening is for everything that Griselda has talked about. Women, you know, get a year off completely paid. Women do not lose their jobs when they have babies. Women have free childcare when they need it, et cetera, et cetera. Women have complete access to all forms of family planning, even though some of those forms are incredibly expensive because of the blockade. So in the last year and a half, beginning at the Fifth Party Communist Party Congress in the People's Assembly, and I don't know if this has been finalized, and maybe Griselda could bring us up to date, there's a whole strategic plan being developed of what Cuba's going to do about this. So this includes, for example, extending the year maternity leave to beyond a year, actually giving the women more money on their maternity leave than they get while they're working, a whole series of incentives, which have never been done anywhere in the world. I mean, this is another revolution that's going on now in Cuba. China never did this when China was a communist country, and neither did anybody else. So it's an incredible new adventure and revolution for the Cubans, that the only way they can solve this problem is collectively with the participation and the leadership of women. So I'd be interested to hear if Griselda could help us understand what's going on with this. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor, for that very illuminating comparison between the United States and Cuba. It's chilling and terrifying, but it's also full of hope for what a revolution can do and what people changing the particular structures that were in place, what that can do. And to some extent, it was a rhetorical question because I could add that Colombia has lived 60 years of civil war. So 60 years of civil war does things to the psyche, the same way that 60 years of revolution will do things to a psyche. But I think it's just posing the question, I think it's important for us to come to terms to what it is to be under different types of war in the United States or in Colombia versus the war actually that Cuba engages with a blockade, which is a different kind of war. So very much appreciated. And very much appreciated that Griselda is speaking from experience as well. And the young woman had a follow-up question, and the gentleman has a follow-up question. That is, this is a very lively group.
I can't help you, I'm curious.
Corre, corre, corre. Sí, igual que ahorita.
Hi,
So part of the basis for this question is my own personal opinion and experience, and some of it is statistics and things that I've read. But I think that part of the reason that sexual harassment and assault are so rampant in this country are because we have very subpar sex education, which sometimes students don't receive sex education at all, or they are taught only abstinence, or they are given wrong information often. And I wanted to know about the way that sex education is handled in Cuba, and if you think that those two have a correlation the way I think they do here.
Bueno, eso también está incluido, aunque ustedes no lo piensen, en los programas de educación en Cuba. En Cuba se le enseña a los niños ya como jóvenes el cuidado que deben tener con vista a las enfermedades de transmisión sexual.
This is something which is included in education in Cuba, including from when children are very young, they begin to get education and including about the dangers of sexually transmitted diseases.
Se les trata como tema específico el embarazo precoz en la adolescencia.
They take up specifically the question of pregnancy, and in particular, pregnancy amongst teenagers.
Y se le habla en general de todos estos temas.
And all of these questions are taken up.
A las aulas donde están hembras y varones.
And there are boys and girls together in the classrooms where these are discussed.
O sea, a ellos se les prepara también con vista a su futuro y a su sexualidad, que ya comienzan a tenerla en la adolescencia.
That is, they're preparing them for their future life and for the sexuality which they are beginning to experience as adolescents.
Se le explican los riesgos inclusive de las diferentes enfermedades de transmisión sexual por la promiscuidad.
They explain the dangers of certain sexually transmitted diseases that can come about from promiscuity.
Y ellos conocen el peligro que tienen ante esta situación.
So they know the dangers that they would face in this kind of situation.
Conocen sobre el VIH-Sida.
They know about HIV and AIDS.
Y cómo es que esta enfermedad se puede evitar utilizando el condón.
And how this disease can be avoided by using condoms.
Porque nunca se sabe a qué edad puede un joven comenzar a tener relaciones sexuales.
Because you never know at what age a young man may begin to have sexual relations.
Entonces, el objetivo es preparar a ese adolescente de una manera científica y muy natural.
And so the aim is to prepare the adolescents in a very scientific manner, but also in a very natural manner.
En cómo lograr evitar cualquier tipo de contagio.
And how to avoid any type of disease.
Que en Cuba no son significativas las enfermedades de transmisión sexual.
And Cuba doesn't have any significant rate of sexually transmitted diseases.
Pero bueno, se les prepara.
But that's because they're prepared.
Y ellos conocen el origen de todas estas enfermedades y el origen del VIH-Sida.
And they know the origins of all of these diseases, including the origins of HIV/AIDS.
O sea que nosotros también en eso tenemos una población preparada.
So we have a population that's prepared to take up these and confront these problems.
No obstante, existen las consultas del médico de familia que ante cualquier problema enseguida asisten.
And of course, everyone has their family doctor nearby, and any problem or situation that arises, they can go right away and have a consultation.
Existen las consultas de planificación familiar.
There are also consultancies for family planning.
Ante un embarazo precoz para saber, de acuerdo con la familia, y con eso, qué medidas se puede tomar.
In the case of an unexpected pregnancy, they will know what options are open to them, what measures could be taken.
Porque como es natural, todas esas cosas pueden pasar.
Because of course, all these things could happen to someone.
O sea, lo que tratamos es de prevenir, y ya cuando ocurre algún tipo de situación, automáticamente la familia tomar las medidas de acuerdo con su área de salud.
While we try to prevent these situations from arising, we know they will happen, and when they do happen, the family knows where they can go to take some measures to deal with it.
O sea que es muy posible que también los problemas que hay entre los jóvenes sea, como la muchacha planteaba, un problema de falta de educación en ese aspecto.
And so it could be that, as the compañera said, the problems amongst young people here is coming from this lack of education.
Yeah.
Okay.
Thank you so much, and gentlemen, have a question as well.
wanted to make a comment about the difference between Cuba and Colombia. Capitalism is a dog-eat-dog system. Everyone out for themselves. And the socialist revolution, one of the most important things it accomplishes, to use Che Guevara's word, is a new man and new women, where solidarity is the main point. It's collective ownership of the resources of the country, not individual ownership and driving for profits. Cuba is based on solidarity. That's why they did what they did in Angola. That's why they did in West Africa for the Ebola. And that's just the beginning of the instances you can give. It's a society based on solidarity. That's the difference between Cuba and Colombia. That's the difference between Cuba and the United States. That's the difference between Cuba and the rest of the capitalist world. The socialist revolution creates new human beings through the struggle to bring down capitalism. And the struggle is successful only to the extent that solidarity is built among the working people and the peasants and so forth. So I just wanted to mention that as why Griselda's description of Cuba is so different than Colombia.
Nosotros nos alegramos mucho el pueblo cubano por los logros que ha tenido el pueblo de Colombia, producto de esa lucha sangrienta que han tenido durante años.
The Cuban people are very glad for what the Colombian people have achieved through this very bloody struggle that lasted so many years.
Tenemos la esperanza y la confianza de que sigan marchando por ese camino.
We have the confidence and the hope that Colombia will continue advancing along this road.
Y cuando pase el tiempo, las mujeres puedan ser capaces de no sentirse acosadas.
And that with the passage of time, women in Colombia will no longer be objects of sexual harassment.
Y puedan ser en ese sentido y en otros más dueñas de sí mismas.
And can be in this sense and in others their own owners of themselves.
Y como mujeres al fin ayuden a la formación de ese hombre nuevo.
And as women, they then make their contribution to the formation of this new man and woman.
Con esa educación en sus derechos, con esa enseñanza hacia la solidaridad de los demás.
With this education about people's rights, and with this education about solidarity with others.
A cómo compartir lo que se tenga.
Of how to share that which you have.
Y cómo ser capaces de crear un mundo nuevo que, como decía Fidel, es posible.
And how it is possible to build a new world, which, as Fidel said, is possible.
Y mucho mejor que el que tenemos hoy en día.
And much better than the one we have today.
For your presence, your very active engagement with this presentation. I am sure that most of us would love to continue speaking. I mean, she finished talking about Colombia, and I'm like, excuse me, I want to continue speaking about Colombia. And I will say 45% of the guerrillas are women. And the majority of those who are part of the peace process in Colombia are women. And they are not sitting feeling victim-y about the situation, but they are actually changing things. Thank you so much to the Department of Sociology for sponsoring, and above all to Stan and all that he does all year round to bring in perspectives that otherwise we will not be available to listen to. And it is this is a pleasure, it is an honor. This is a very, very important occasion for us, and I'm sure that none of us will forget this opportunity to listen to you. Thank you.
Thank you.